The Public Health Amendment Bill of 2021, which seeks to control the spread of infectious diseases, provides for mandatory mass vaccination in case of an outbreak that requires vaccination or revaccination. The proposal empowers local government councils to force anyone eligible to be vaccinated.
Many a times when we introduce new vaccines, it is important that we get a mass of people so that we can create herd immunity. And usually what we have been doing is issuing statutory instruments to guide, just like we were doing during this time of COVID. In the Public Health Act Amendment Bill, that is already provided for, and it is important that whoever is supposed to be vaccinated should be vaccinated.
And therefore, if we do not have stringent measures to ensure that everyone gets vaccinated, it means therefore that the unvaccinated will not be playing their role of protecting those who may be exposed to it. So it is very important that we have stringent laws and have it as a mandatory provision itself.
In this regard, Clause 47(2) of the bill proposes the penalty of 200 currency points, which translates to 4 million shillings or imprisonment for not exceeding 6 months or both to those who will fail to comply with mandatory vaccination.
Those who resist vaccination and yet they know that they will obviously be a danger to the public, to the people that they interrelate with, obviously will have to undergo some punitive measures.
This provision has divided members of parliament, as some contend that it is a human rights violation to take away people's freedom to decide whether they get immunized or not.
I think the best way would be to sensitize, to engage more in sensitizing the public of the importance of vaccination, then to also ensure that, the vaccines are got in time and in plenty.
In case there are side effects, how are they countered? If somebody opts out, what would be the effect in the event? Is still safe and not sick? So those are the gaps that need to be addressed before this amendment is perhaps considered.
Yeah, in my opinion, mandatory vaccination is very necessary, especially if we can learn from what has happened with the COVID-19. That after people being vaccinated, you can see how the economy has been opened.
The bill, which seeks to repeal the Immunization Act of 2017, provisions of the Venereal Diseases Act, provisions of Building Control Act, and provisions of Water Act Cap 152, revises and beefs up penalties for offenses committed under the Act. For example, failure to report unusual sickness or death attracts a fine of 4 million shillings or a custodial sentence of 6 months or both. However, the committee contends that some penalties are not deterrent enough.
And I felt the penalty was up to, I think, 500,000 shillings, as may be decided by the presiding officer. I think people who spread, I hope councillors, I wish councillors around, but I shall look for that clause. I think these are industries or entrepreneurs, but who willingly or knowingly participate in the spread of disease. That penalty for me, I think, was a bit too small. That's pocket change for some of these.
The Public Health Amendment Bill of 2021 provides for punishments without prosecution. In this regard, the minister, in consultation with other stakeholders, shall make rules for offences created by this act for which a person who commits an offence is penalised.
So, in much as we need the surveillance and to make an outlook of any outbreak, there is need to have a people-centred approach. These provisions, however, are just a matter of panic. We needed some good time to take a good study of all the unfoldings. Perhaps for now we are looking at COVID or Ebola, which of course has been contained at some level. But there could come another severe disease. So we need a bill to focus, to be broader, not to focus entirely on COVID, which has almost been suppressed.
Right now, there are new emerging public health threats, epidemics like Ebola, Marburg, pandemics like COVID. So we definitely have to amend the bill to be able to take care of that. We have to repeal certain sections of the Act. You know, we decentralized, I think, in 1995. And that was after the Act had already been done. So we need to look at the interface between the central government and the local governments.
The Parliamentary Committee of Health now moves to consult other stakeholders on the provisions of the bill before reporting back to Parliament. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.